Okay, the time is 6:01. Can we stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I want to thank you all for coming. If you're a non-voter and do not live in the Freeport Township, we want you to sit on this side. If you are a voter and live in Freeport Township, we would like you to sit on this side because we'll be voting on some issues and we need to know who can vote and who can't. First thing on the agenda now is the establishment of the salary of the moderator and the annual town meeting. I'll entertain a motion for a moderator's salary. Mr. Sellers.
Entertain a motion to set the moderator's salary for $50.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of the salary of $50 for the moderator, please raise your hands. All opposed? You don't count. Okay, now, the election, we need to elect a moderator. I'm open for nominations. Mr. Sellers.
I make a motion to elect John Staben as the moderator.
And do I hear a second?
Second.
And that was Cindy, okay. And is there any discussion? Any other nominations? Okay, I need a motion to close the nominations.
So who motion?
Mr. Mike?
Mike.
Mike. And who seconded it?
Second.
Burns. Okay, nominations are now, all in favor of closing nominations, please signify by raising your hand. Thank you. All right, now, Mr. Staben. We were going to vote on Mr. Staben's ability to be our moderator. All in favor? Any opposed? Would you please come up, Mr. Mataker? I'm going to give you the oath.
I sit here?
Yeah, but come over here.
Okay.
Raise your right. I do solemnly swear or affirm.
I do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
That I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
The duties of the moderator of this town meeting.
The duties of the moderator of this town meeting.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Thank you. Would you sign here, please? Okay, it's all yours now. You can sit right there.
That's nice. All righty. We have presentation of township minutes is the first item on the agenda. Item four, I understand Barbara, you will be doing that?
Presentation of the minutes, everybody should have a copy of the minutes. We just need to have them approved. And you can do them either together or separately, however you want to do it, because there's two sets of minutes.
All right, do I have a motion to approve the minutes as a combined package?
I move so moved.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second. Is there any discussion on the minutes? That's too easy. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. The minutes are approved. That's too easy. All right, next item on the agenda is to read the annual financial report. And it's my understanding that you all have the annual financial report. Is there any, do I need a motion?
I need to read it.
Fine. Please read the annual, the financial report.
Funds on hand beginning of the fiscal year is $1,891.60. The amount received from all sources, $1,146,924.38. The amount expended for all purposes, $849,614.24. Funds on hand end of fiscal year, $1,389,676.37. The amount of tax levied this preceding year is $1,484,000. The amount of property tax collected, $956,925.35. The amount paid on town indebtedness was zero, principal was zero, interest was zero. The amount of unpaid liabilities, $18,911.15. This was as of March 31st, 2016.
All right, I would like a motion to approve the financial report to put it on file. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
I have a motion to approve and place the financial report on file. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second. Is there any discussion on the financial report? Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The amount levied and amount collected, we're short about what, $43,569? Am I correct on that?
I'm sorry, I can't answer that. I just read the information. I can't answer that. Can you answer that, Mr. Sellers?
In other words, we levied $1,484,000, but we only collected. So we were short about $43,000 at what we levied, right?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Approximately. I'm not looking for detail, mm-hmm. but approximately.
Yeah.
March.
Okay, I have one more question. Just give me a minute to find it. I just had a note on here.
53.
3 minutes, please.
Do we have any recording on here, maybe Mr. Sellers can answer this, about how much money we took out of our reserve at the beginning of the fiscal year in order to balance our budget?
No, we have to amend the budget at all, so we didn't take anything out of the reserve. So no money come out of the reserve.
So what was our total budget projection, rough figure then?
You don't have the budget with you?
I do. What is it? I'm just asking you.
What we budgeted for? We budgeted what? What do we budget, Cindy?
I don't know. If she's got it, she should be the one to tell
me. $1,000,006, I think?
No, I can't, because I've heard from here. I'm just asking you to clarify it for me.
Well, here's what you do. You contact the fiscal officer. She'll let you know exactly what everything is. We actually want to bring information with them tonight to the meeting, our board members. So you should know what our budget. I think we're at budget for $1,000,000.
Current or last year?
Current or last year? You want current or last year?
Well, I came up with about if you're talking about our existing budget, I came up with about $91,000 that came out of reserves in order to
No money come out of reserves. Everything was done in line item transfers within the budget, so no money come out of reserves this year. No.
At this point, I think I'm going to hold a conversation. The conversation has moved to an area that is not a part of the financial report that is read. It's futures. We need to focus on questions related to the financial report that's been read.
But this is out of the financial report.
But is this next year's budget or last year's budget?
No.
Well, if it's on the financial report,
I'm reading from the figure of $1,048,538.09.
Okay, so that is the number. What is the question?
And the question is how much if we only receive $956,926, then
you had a shortage of
$40,000. $91,000 from reserves.
No, we did not remove any money from reserves.
That answered the question.
Tell me what those figures are, because then I'm reading this wrong. Right.
Those figures are not a part of this report, are they?
The reserves, no. The report that the only thing that we know of was what's here. That information that we have here. What she's asking is something that I think only the fiscal manager can answer. I don't think it's anything that's on here that we can answer the question.
Then it is not a part of this report.
If there's details of information beyond under these pages that she can look at, and maybe we'll answer her questions. But
okay. At this point, I think the 3 minutes has expired on the question. Do we have any other questions?
We have a motion and a second.
Yes, we do. If there are no other questions, I would take a vote. All in favor of accepting the report and placing it on file, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
All right, we have one opposed. The motion has carried. Please place the report on file.
Thank you.
All right, we are now moving on to the annual report of the officers of the town board. Are the assessors going to make a statement? I would like to, the assessor's report. I would like the assessor's report. I'm learning.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you for those that are here tonight. Most of you know what I do, but you know, it's always kind of one of those things where you kind of have to recap it anyway. So what does the assessor's office do? It's a statutory responsibility of the assessor to value all properties within their jurisdiction, both fairly and equitably, establishing market. The office is responsible to establish values for 10,500 parcels in Freeport Township. Our budget last year was $241,476. The average cost to value a parcel is roughly $23. Now, if you are a fee appraiser, which does an individual appraisal, you're roughly $250 on up. So I guess I look at what we do and the services we provide for Freeport Township to be very cost productive and reasonable, extremely reasonable. And if you look at one of the handouts you would have received, there's a picture of a dollar bill. Freeport Township gets 4 cents of that dollar bill. And we operate primarily totally on property taxes. So I just wanted to give you an idea, 4 cents per dollar. The values for the properties in the last 4 years have declined. Unfortunately, we've seen it dwindle. And roughly, you could say your properties lost 8% since 2012. This year, again, I foresee it to go down. Which properties specifically? Before, we did across the board adjustments downward with a negative multiplier. 2016 is a quadrennium. That means we basically now remove all adjustments made to any properties over the last 4 years. All multipliers are removed. We then recalculate and redo our tables and value with the new 2016 established market value. And I wanted to share just a little bit that sometimes when we do this valuation, we'll find specific properties that are valued higher than others. And we go back to 2012 because it was very clear for us in 2012, ranches were more popular and derived a higher value than two stories. And during that time, we had to try to figure out why this was occurring. And much in part is because we have an aging population. People are looking for ranches, smaller, less land. Just in general, they want to compact themselves and become smaller and not so much square footage. Briefly, let me tell you about your handouts. You've got one handout here, which talks about what we do, who we are, why we do what we do, exemptions, and other information that you might find very interesting. So you have that one. The other one was the dollar bill, which I just enjoy because people always want to ask where your tax dollars go. As I said, Freeport Township gets 4 cents on the dollar, and that's it. The next one is understanding your assessment in relationship to a tax bill. This is, again, interesting. We'll set the value, then the rate is set. Unbeknownst to a lot of people that used to like to say, I establish the values for the taxing bodies. Well, that's not the case. We establish the values, then the rate's derived. And this gives you a few scenarios where if your value went up and the taxing bodies did their due diligence and didn't raise their rate, your tax bill would actually go down. So it's just, again, another piece of information to show you what could happen with the differences in taxing and how things have happened. Next one is the real estate tax cycle, which clearly tells you I don't do and establish values for the taxing body. We set the values, they're established, then the rate is calculated. And the final is a letter from Brian Smith, who is the TOI executive director. And he references to the Cox report, which you can go online and do some research yourself. But basically, it's talking about, they keep saying the state of Illinois has one of the largest, if not the largest, number of government entities. Well, the Cox report talks about that and talks about it's not the number of governing agencies, it's the efficiency and the cost efficiency that's needs to be in place. All right, so I've done my spiel on what the assessor does, but I am going to take a moment. And I always have to be careful because our attorney kind of looks at me, but I've got it written down, so I won't do anything foolish. I'd like to touch briefly on the legislative bodies in the state of Illinois and the impact that they're having on townships throughout the state. In the infinite wisdom of our state reps and senators, there seems to be a move to get rid of townships by one method or another. There currently are 15 different pieces of legislation, 8 currently in the Senate. For us here in Freeport, where the numbers and clients have been reduced, which reduced the number of employees, which overall has reduced our total budgets, we're unclear as to why the legislation wants to do something like this, okay? Personally, I look at our state operations to the federal government and do a comparison. The poor direction of our governments from federal to state to county to city is a trickle-down effect. The public has shown their discontent with how our politics is operating, and all you have to do is watch the television. You'll see how our presidential candidates are behaving. They look at our, and then you look at our state. We didn't get a budget for 2015-16. We aren't going to see one for 16 and 17 until after the election in November. This is what we pay our legislative bodies to do, not do their job. One example of the actions, and I look at the city, and I am told I have a methodology of being shaking my head, and my husband calls it incongruent. Well, I look at how our city government right now currently behaves, and I shake my head a lot. One of the examples that their newfound wisdom was is to remove corporation counsel and outsource it to a law firm. We'll see how financially smart that was and how much money we're going to save. I'd like to say to each and every one of you this evening, if the elected officials followed similarly to Freeport Township since the change in 2013, what a difference it may make. Granted, we're much smaller scale, but we are doing something right as we are making a difference in our township. From the assessing perspective, it's pretty cut and dry. Value fairly and equitably. But from the supervisor's division, where the real change has happened, doing more with less, making clients accountable, teaching them to be self-sufficient and more, you couldn't ask for anything more. And I am shaking my head. The day they come after Freeport Township and try to get rid of it, I have to ask them, what are you going to replace us with? I believe our legislative body needs to draw attention away from their lack of ability to do their job. I can hear them now saying, no, it's his fault. No, it's not, it's his fault. It's time to set aside their petty politics and get the job done, because that's what we're paying you for. I get frustrated, so I have to stay back on my paper. They say the proof is in the pudding. Show me how much you're going to save us by getting rid of the township. Show me where the savings is in the state, in the county, and the city. There are no duplication of services as they would like to imply. We do our job for Freeport Township. Supervisor Sellers does his job for Freeport Township. There is no duplication. There's no mirror of services. You can't go anywhere and get his, and you can't go anywhere else and get your values. You come to Freeport Township. Enough said. We will, of course, be watching our local representative and senator and see how they vote in this next upcoming legislation. And I want to thank you again. If you have any questions on the handouts that you were given, name, phone number, address, they're all there for you. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we will turn the podium over to the Township Supervisor, Mr. Seller.
Good evening, all. I'm Patrick Seller, Supervisor of your Freeport Township. 2015 marked another successful year for the Township, assisting clients that needed our help, eliminating the ones that really didn't, implementing and perfecting programs, all the while keeping a watchful eye on your tax dollars, has made 2015 Freeport Township's most triumphant year thus far. It is my pleasure to stand before you, the taxpayers, and inform you that this administration, since 2013, has worked diligently to take care of Township from the brink of financial collapse to the golden shores of financial stability. Doing more with less has been the philosophy of this administration. We've taken that concept and we've ran with it. With our fiscal year coming to an end on April 30th, 2016, your Township is once again projected to save money from the 2015 budget to the tune of $252,000, putting this organization even further in the black. So where's all the money going, you're asking? Well, it goes back into the budget and ultimately back into your pocket. See, for the last two fiscal years, your Freeport Township has done the unthinkable. We've lowered our levies and we've lowered our budgets. Can you believe that? The national government doing what it's supposed to do. Using only what it needs, holding true to its budget while asking for less of your hard-earned money. Sounds like a utopian style of government, doesn't it? Well, to me, it sounds like your Freeport Township is one of the most, if not the most, efficient and effective governments in this city. Not bragging, just stating the fact. By the grace of God, we've transformed your township into one that you can be proud of, and we are not finished yet. I'm also pleased to inform you that through our consistency, hard work, and dedication, we are successfully rebranding your township, changing the public perception from township benefits being free to township benefits being earned. Every client that receives township benefits has earned those benefits. Make no mistake about it. We're relentless with this practice, and our clients as well as our potential clients know it. We are constantly driving the message of empowerment, not entitlement, home. And through our efforts and your support, we are changing the very way your township is viewed. Our recently recognized Iron and Working Training Program has been one of the cornerstones upon which we've rebuilt and reformed your township. Controlling client numbers, encouraging self-sufficiency, and empowering all participants to grow far beyond their own perceived limitations illustrates what the Iron and Program is all about. It is also the umbrella for many of our other township programs. Programs such as Right Direction, which has grown in leaps and bounds since 2015. Collaborating with businesses such as Snack King, Dura, Manpower, and agencies such as Stevenson County Probation and the Department of Human Services has not only given Right Direction participants the opportunity to learn exactly what it is employers are looking for, but it also provides extra leverage to encourage self-sufficiency. The Right Direction program is a constantly evolving program designed to keep up with the fast pace and changing climate of business itself and life itself. This helps keep our content fresh, which in turn challenges the program participants to look at their current situations, take ownership of their situations, and improve their lives. The BOSS program, which is an acronym for Building Our Sons Successfully, is also starting to gather steam. The program focuses on mothers of at-risk young men, strengthening the participating mothers and providing them with the tools necessary to help guide their sons to successful futures. Through our collaboration with FSD 145, and the Regional Office of Education, as well as other interested partners, the BOSS program will continue to grow and reach the families that need it most. These and all other township programs are original programs written and facilitated by township employees. So needless to say that the Freeport Township staff and myself works very hard for you, the taxpayers, and we will continue to do so. Now, let's switch gears here a little bit. This is going to make my attorney look at me over his glasses. You know what I mean? When I say so. But I'm going to say it anyway. There was a comment made at a Golden Kiwanis meeting by our state representative, Mr. Brian Stewart. Now, this comment was in reference to how much the township gives out in assistance versus how much the township spends in administrative costs. Okay, so Representative Stewart said Pat Sellers' office, supervisor's office, my office, spends $200,000 in assistance given, and also spends $700,000 in administrative costs. Okay, that would be quite disturbing. $200,000 in assistance given, that's about right. But $700,000, I got a problem with that, because that's not correct. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you guys the exact figures and facts. Your Freeport Township, so far in 2015-16, has given out $217,000 in assistance and has spent $160,000 in administrative costs. So there is a $539,000 difference between what's fact and what was said. Statements such as this that are arbitrarily made must be addressed and corrected by the people who know. We know. So now it's up to me to find out where he got his numbers from, because they were not correct. So that's my next little super sloop maneuver. I'm going to find out how he got his numbers, because I want to find out. Now, Mike, I'm putting the train back on the track.
Thank you.
Okay. For the last two fiscal years, we've reduced client numbers, we've reduced staff, we lowered our levies, we lowered our budgets, and in that same two-year time period, we have saved your township $514,000. So we've asked for less, budgeted less, spent less, and saved more. Wow, isn't that a great concept? Here we are, the current administration, holding true to our promises, making our clients earn their assistance, and enabling people for self-sufficiency, and not disabling them for the sake of numbers. You guys catch that last little phrase I made? We're not disabling people for the sake of numbers, okay? Township is a stepping stone. It's not a way of life. It's not a retirement plan. You come to township, we get you on your feet, we move you on. That's how it works, okay? Keeping our costs down, returning money to the budget, lowering the budget, lowering the levies, providing state-mandated services, all the while writing, implementing, perfecting, and facilitating original programs in order to help improve the overall quality of life for all Freeport Township residents. All of them. That's what we do. Your township has done these things, and have done them in a minimal amount of time, and for 4 cents on the dollar. Man, that's it. 4 cents on the dollar. Can anyone else tell me where you can get that kind of bang for your buck? You can't get it from the city, I'll tell you that much. Or from the state, either. But you got it right here in Freeport Township. Ladies and gentlemen, are we doing something that's amazing and just so great? No. Effectiveness and efficiency is what you should demand of your government. Good stewardship of your tax dollars is what you should demand of your government. Fair and just processes and procedures is what you should demand of your government. Honesty, integrity combined with high morals and values is what you should demand of your government. And when such demands are compromised, when such demands aren't honored or met, it tears at the very fabric of this great democracy. And those are tears that this city, this township, this county, this state, this country cannot afford. We can't afford those kind of tears, okay? As the sun sets in the time of this current administration, and the sun is setting on us, we look back at all the storms that we weathered and overcame, all the setbacks that set the stage for our comebacks. We count our blessings in the many lives that we've changed, the minds that we've enlightened, as well as the client numbers that we've reduced and the tax dollars that we saved. And for those things, we are eternally thankful. But there will always be storms to weather, setbacks to come back from, arduous decisions that demand keen and astute minds in order to help navigate your township into further success. And as we brace ourselves for challenges ahead, standing battered and bruised by the test of time, we remain fearless and steadfast, unyielding and unwavering, grounded and focused, confident in our abilities to overcome such future challenges, and through it all, emerging as a shining example of how good government is supposed to work. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Thank you, Mr. Sellers. All right, we now come to item C, the physical report, annual financial statement. Is that being presented by the
CFO? This is what I read, the pages after that will give you information on the financial statements on our budget and what we spent and all that kind of neat stuff. So if there's any questions, we'll try to answer them, but I'm not going to promise.
I'm not asking for any figures, is that?
No question.
She's asking.
I just a question. I have a comment. I don't know in regard to Patrick's. I don't think at this point or later in the meeting. I would just like to comment on your remarks. If you want me to do that later, I don't want to get out of tune here.
I think we've hold the thought.
Okay.
We've already moved on to the physical report, so
okay, fine.
I'll remember you.
Okay, thank you.
You bet. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Since the financial statement, Barb, as I read it, and I think it's very clear in there, is only for an 11-month period. It is not for the full year. And of course, I understand those are projected figures, but we still have another month, you know, for actual budget costs. Everything that is in here is based on ending at the end of March. As you know, this is April 12th. Our fiscal year doesn't really end until the end of April. So there are some costs in here, but there are some costs out there yet that are not going to be reported.
Okay.
I just wanted to make that clear.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any other discussion on the annual physical statement? We don't have to put that on file, do we?
No, it's already on file.
Okay. All right.
Yep, that's
moving on. Item D, board members. Would any of the board members like to make a statement? Certainly.
We are in the process.
Would you state your name?
Yeah, state your name.
I'm Mickey Martin. I'm an elected township trustee. I've served on the town board for 8 years now, a little more. Can't remember. I have some issues that I think we had discussed at our meeting. We were unable to pass the budget. And the reason for that was there was some question about the amount of raises staff have been given. So what I did was a budget comparison analysis starting in 2014-15, going to 2015-16, and then what we're projecting for 2016-17. There was $9,861.94 increase in staff salaries between 2015 and 2016 budget. Now, the big discussion we were having for our 2016-2017 budget was there is again $9,346 in raises that the staff have been given. Now, we know that in 2014-15 we had 4.5 staff. In 2015-16 we had 4.5 staff up until when we had lost a staff person. And it was that person was not replaced. Is that correct? Mr. Sellers, that person was not replaced. Okay, so 2016-17 budget, we only have 3.5 staff. So I'm baffled that we are increasing salaries at such a rate when I hear Mr. Sellers tell us that we saved the taxpayers all these dollars because we reduced our caseload, we've been the steward of our taxes, and yet, where are those extra funds going? They're going to the staff. So I think what I'd like to share with you is that I am a current elected township trustee with over 25 years experience, first as a member of the Freeport City Council when we were a township committee of the city, and as chairperson for the township committee for a number of years. Excuse me. So none of this is really new to me. But in looking at the salaries on a budget comparison analysis, there were no consistencies with the raises. Some were getting large raises, some smaller raises, and in some cases, no raise. The salary line items continue to show monies being spent, even though a case supervisor left before Christmas. It raises the question that even more raises were possibly given in 2015-2016 than were actually shown. In other words, when did the salary increases for last year begin? In other words, we are looking at salaries that we really don't know when they began and when they started changing. As a board member, I was not informed of changes in the salary structure and when they took place. I believe the taxpayers of a taxing body have a right to know how their tax dollars are being used. We have no personnel policy with salary grades or dollar amounts for those grades. We do have personnel policies which address vacation, they address benefits, but they do not address any grades or salary amounts. I believe the staff are truly diligent and are doing their job, but it is my belief that the salaries are highly inflated for an office our size. While the budget this year was decreased by $155,000 and the caseload was down to 39 clients, of which 11 of those are Social Security and are not required to work, so we really had 28 clients that required active ongoing review. Again, township will be reimbursed for all the money that they spent on the Social Security clients that we are paying until they get their awards. So we're not losing any money on those Social Security clients that we are funding. We all know that the Freeport economy is still struggling, and as businesses have left, people are taking lesser paying jobs and not moving up but losing income. I am the chairperson of the 708 board that funds not-for-profit service agencies in this community. I am acutely aware that caseloads are increasing in that arena and that the staff are being asked to take on more responsibility with no pay increases. In some cases, medical benefits have been cut to some of those agencies. In other instances, there has been no raises for over 5 years. In other cases, directors are now taking on accounting responsibility and case manager responsibility because they can no longer afford those positions. We cannot compare ourselves to large state bureaucracies, but we must look around at our own community service agencies and what they are doing as a comparison. Excuse me. While the assessor's office does not present the same difficulty in determining raises, if you look at their salaries, they continue to spiral on the high side. Is this how we want our taxpayer dollars to be used, or are there more efficient ways to do the same job in the assessor's office as well as the township office? Are there, and I'm just raising the question, are there other agencies that could absorb the jobs for less? We have read Representative Stewart's column about not the township, but the highest number of government and entities in Illinois, more than any other state in our union, let alone the number of government entities in Stevenson County alone. As an elected township trustee, I cannot support these raises of taxpayers who are daily struggling to make ends meet. Maybe it's time that we raise some questions about what we're doing.
Thank you.
Ask for clarification. Patrick, and maybe you can answer this. Mm-hmm. She said that there had 39 clients, 11 of which are Social Security. Is that accurate? Because that's not how I understand it.
Yes.
That's not the entire year. That's okay. The case count right now.
Okay. The case count is right. 39, 11 are Social Security.
Well, actually, the case count now is 42.
Okay. That's fine. I was just going on the latest figures that you gave, excuse yourself. I'm not asking. I'm not privy to a daily count.
Okay, I think it's a report. It'll stand as presented. I think that's something for your business meeting.
Except, excuse me, moderator, statement. Except there's statements being made that are false, that need to be cleared, and for those people that are present this evening, they may not attend or watch our previous meetings. The numbers she gave, she gave some numbers, but I believe we should have the opportunity to set the record straight this evening and not delay that.
Would another board member wish to address that? Or trustee, pardon me.
Right, because I'm the only other board member here, so Joyce Sellers, elected trustee board member. I do feel that there were questions when we had our board meeting, but I also think that we don't understand that might be a situation right now with our clients and what we have, but we don't know what tomorrow or next week or next month will bring, so we might have more clients. But I do think that people that are working in township, that the jobs that they're doing more jobs for less, and I understand other entities might cut back or whatever, but you can't always do the same thing somebody else is doing, but because they are writing their own programs and implementing programs to help clients to get back on their feet. So I do feel that, I know that when we first got into township, Supervisor Sellers did lower all the salaries. So I do feel that as time goes on, they do deserve to have pay raises. Everybody does in their jobs, you know. But so I can't quote everything that Supervisor Trustee Martin has said. But I do think that they do deserve raises. I mean, everybody deserves a raise if you work hard every day. And I do think that they are working hard in township. And I do believe that with them working hard, that's why we are in the situation we are now, because we did spend way more money and pay a lot higher salaries than what they do now. So I do think that, yeah, they are working with less and we have saved more, but I would like to go back in time and see if we've saved as much money as we have saved, this administration has saved right now in township. So I do believe that they do deserve raises.
Thank you. Are there any other trustees that would like to make a statement? This is not a debate.
No, I'm just going to quote my sources.
Well, that's it. Report's been made.
I'm just going to tell you what my sources were for the information that I have, because anyone can go and do what I did.
All right, you have quick sources.
Okay. In 2014, I had to do a FOIA request as a town trustee in order to get the entry salary wages for Mr. Seller's staff, which I did do. And they're very clear, they're very clear. Anybody wants a copy, they can have them. Then, the other thing that I requested from Mr. Sellers, which he gave me, was an email last April 4th, in which he gave me the current salaries of everybody. And that's where, when I then went back to the budget comparisons, I took our budget, our actual budget, and I took our budget comparisons.
Again, the sources you've provided.
Yes.
That's all we're looking for is the sources.
And the budgets that we did for 3 years in a row.
Okay.
And that were passed by the board, which included those salary figures.
And they're on file.
Anybody can take that information and find the very same thing that I did.
Okay. Thank you very much. Any other trustee would like to make a report? Hearing none, we will move on to the general assistance. Barbara, do you handle that?
Vote at 1 mil for general. We just make a motion and a second.
There needs to be a motion made to approve.
All right. I need a motion to approve maintaining the $1 million for general assistance.
One mil.
One mil.
I made that mistake too. It's called one mil.
All right. We need a motion to maintain 1 mil for general assistance.
So.
We have a motion.
Second.
We have a second.
Sellers and sellers.
Yep. Do we have any discussion on the motion? Hearing no discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. The motion passes. Moving along. We now have disposal of surplus obsolete equipment.
You all have a list, or you should have in your packet that you picked up. There's a resolution that I will read, and the list, as soon as I find it. Okay, here's the resolution. I'm going to read this resolution. Do you want me to go to the podium?
Yes, Mr.
please. Cameraman? Resolution, donation of town personnel property to historical society or another non-for-profit corporation. Be it resolved by the electors of the town of Freeport and the county of Stevenson, state of Illinois, that effective immediately and pursuant to section 30-53 of the township code of the state of Illinois, codified as 60 ILCS 130-53 as amended. The town board of trustees are authorized by approving a duly enacted resolution to donate to one or more historical societies or any other not-for-profit corporation any or all of the items for personal property currently owned by the town of Freeport, which appear in the documented list as Exhibit A, which is this document right here. Obsolete equipment, which document is incorporated by reference as it fully set forth herein. And each such item on the aforesaid Exhibit A is hereby declared to be not needed now or in the future for the operations of the town of Freeport, and thus are surplus for purpose of donating the property to a historical society or other not-for-profit corporation as provided in section 80-75 of the Township Code of the State of Illinois. And on that list, we have 10 to 15 four-drawer filing cabinets, 30 miscellaneous office chairs, a Konica Minolta copier, two black toners for the Minolta top copier, two Dell 8x620 desktop towers, two Dell 740 desktop towers, four Dimension Dell 3100 desktop towers, two Dell 745 desktop towers, one Dell 380 desktop tower, one 15-inch monitor, two Microsoft keyboards, and Pentax ZX30 camera film driver plus film rolls.
All right, do I have a motion to approve this resolution?
So moved.
I have a motion. Do I have a second to that motion?
Second.
I have a motion to end a second. Any discussion on the resolution? Yes, ma'am.
Just a question, Mark. Does the Historical Society have their request in for some equipment already?
Not to my knowledge.
Oh. I could put, you had mentioned it, that's why I asked.
Well, it's in the resolution, if they wanted to, yeah, but it's not.
It's just
they
as
have
an
a,
example.
No, yes.
It's a quotation from the statute. The statute
okay.
says historical society or other not-for-profit corporation.
Okay.
That's
you.
Why we use that language.
Any other question in the back?
Question. Name is John Franklin. These properties that are listed as being obsolete, are they being replaced by other equipment?
Are they what?
Being replaced by other equipment.
Yeah, some of it is excess equipment and some of it has been replaced.
Any other questions? Hearing none, I would like a vote on the item. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it, the resolution is approved. All right, are we going to run this? That comes.
We should do that before we adjourn.
Okay, so we can do that now.
You can do it now.
Because we're down
don't
to other
you
business.
Do you have any other business?
Or? Well, let's do this resolution and then we can.
Well, this for the, okay, I'll read this in a minute.
We have another resolution.
Resolution for setting the time for the 2017 annual town meeting. Be it resolved by the electors of the town of Freeport and the county of Stevenson, state of Illinois, that the 2017 annual town meeting in the town of Freeport be set for April 11th, 2017 at 6:01 p.m.
All right, we have a resolution before us. Do I hear a motion to approve?
So moved.
We have a motion to approve. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second. Any discussion on the resolution? Hearing none. Yes, sir.
Question?
Sure.
The next meeting again has been scheduled like this one prior to the actual end of the fiscal year.
That's by state statute.
State statute requires it to be on the second Tuesday of April. Or if all 1,400 townships in the state of Illinois are meeting tonight, after 6 p.m. to have their annual town meeting, we don't have a choice about that. The state statute sets the day we have to meet.
Any other discussion or questions? Hearing none. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. The ayes have it. The resolution is passed. All right, we come to any other business before the township. No, we have none. We now come to item left off, public comment, sir. You're on.
My name is Mike Reichert, and I am with the Freeport Holding in Kiwanis. Actually, I am the one who arranged programs. In particular, we had Mr. Seller speak at one point, and I thought it was great. And of course, also our township assessor here, she spoke recently and did a great job. But I was surprised because I also arranged Brian Stewart to come and speak. And I didn't want to get into the politics, but when he stated those facts that you just alluded to, I was surprised. I thought, oh my goodness. And then needless to say, there was a lot of reverberation on behalf of, and rightfully so, because I didn't know. And I want to delve into this a little bit more, and I'll support you 100%, because in my estimation, I think you folks have been doing an outstanding job, and I'm proud of you, because we supported you way back. So I just want to let you know that Freeport Golden Cake, we had nothing there, but wow, were we surprised. And I want to know we're back to you, and we'll talk more, because we want to get to stay with Representative Stewart. And he's a good man, and he must have got some information that was not appropriate. So thank you. We'll talk later.
All right. Any other comments from the public? Yes, sir.
Yeah. Steve Carroll. I'm
yes.
On Oak Street. I think I just recently kind of started hanging around Pat in the office and didn't know much about township. And Pat's doing a hell of a great job. I thought it would take him 4 years to put out the dumpster fire. He did it in two, and I think it's well done. Also, as we find the city of Freeport shrinking and the city government becoming more dysfunctional, I think more and more people are going to be turning to township. Unfortunately for Pat, I've kind of done this with issues that the city, for whatever reason, won't deal with. And Pat listens, city doesn't. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. And that is a major compliment.
I don't do it often.
But it's appreciated when you do.
Yes, it is.
Any other comments from the public? Yes, ma'am.
I do, sir. Again, you know, Cynthia Petticon, Freeport Township Assessor. I just need to clarify a few things from Trustee Martin, who was trustee for many, many years. And we can go back. And I really dislike doing this because you try to put the past to rest, but it continues to surface. She was a trustee, we can go back as far as back as probably 2009 and beyond, but my spreadsheet at this point only takes in budget year 2009 and 10.
Speak up, please, Cindy.
When the township budgeted $1,107,502, amended it to $1,128,000. I guess where I'm getting, we levied more than what we were going to have. We levied
our levy met less.
Duh.
We were short $116,000 that year. The following year, 2010 and 11, the levy was short $228,468. 2011 and 12, the levy was short $492,866. Then we get to 2012-13. The infamous year, the levy was short $861,237 from what was budgeted. 2013-14, when Patrick took the office, we started to see a decline. It went down, it was only $490,000. Then it went down another $130,000 in 14-15, down another $147,000 in 15-16. As we continue to progress and take our budget and the tie to the levy, we're differing this year $188,916. That's how tight the townships made it. And when I hear someone tell me that salaries for my staff are spiraling, and that person doesn't take into consideration that my staff, including myself, has 88 years of time in, mine 36, 21, 16, and 15. I'm not sure what you thought these people were worth after that many years in. But to come in and come and point fingers at my office or his when you were a participant in all of those years, when those salaries went crazy high for two people, only two people, I'd like you to redirect your thinking on that. That's all I have.
All right, any other comments from the public? Yes, sir.
Again, a question. Relative to the financial report, we're only seeing 1 year at a time. Again, it's been discussed about multiple years. Is there any reason why we cannot be presented the financial report that covers this year or last year and the prior to that?
Is there a report?
The reports are on file, and you're welcome to any of those reports. Just go to the township office and let the financial officer know what you want, and she'll be happy to provide that. You will have to fill out a FOIA report form, and she'll be able to give that to you. Is that right?
No.
No, I'm not right.
You don't have to go to the office. You can send it an email and saying, I'd like a FOIA information on this. You don't. There's no special form you have to use.
That's right.
And you don't have to take a trip down there to ask for it. You know. But it should be in some submit a writing so it's clear what you want. Sometimes on the phone there's misunderstandings. That's why almost all government bodies that I know request that it be in writing, either email, snail mail, or however you want to do it.
When we're done, I'll give you my email address if you want, and you can send it to me because I'm the FOIA officer. So just I'll be happy to provide that information for you if you want.
Okay, any other comments from the public?
Mr. Saban, would you like to make a statement?
Yes.
That Mr. Saban has temporarily vacated the chair of moderator so he can participate as making a comment.
As a citizen of the city of Freeport, I feel that the amount of money paid the moderator is outrageous. So I am donating the $50 to the township so they can pay the moderator. I'm sorry, you have to have a little fun with it. You have to have a little fun with it. All right, any other comments? All right. There being no further business to come before this annual town meeting of the town of Freeport, Stevenson County, Illinois, is there a motion to adjourn this annual town meeting?
So, who said that, please?
Joy,
thank you.
Is there a second to that motion?
Second.
We have a second. Do we need discussion on that? Is there any discussion? All right. All in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed to the motion say nay. None. Motion carries, and the 2016 annual town meeting of the town of Freeport is declared as closed and adjourned.